You're considered the greatest bodybuilder on the planet, and this youngster just came along and beat you at your own game.
I don't think so. I don't see it that way. So they see it the way they want to see it. I see it the way I want to see it. So that's it. We'll see who wins the show. That's what it's all about.
Well, it will be interesting to see.
Hey guys, so I stumbled upon this interesting moment in 2005 Mr. Olympia, where Ronnie Coleman lost against Gustavo Badel in the challenge round. So this is something they introduced back in 2004. It's really complicated how this challenge round works, but basically the winner of the challenge round is not the winner of the Mr. Olympia competition. So basically, top 6 competitors would all challenge each other. They would choose who they want to challenge and which pose they want to do against the other guy. And every time you win a challenge, you gain 2 points. And eventually, the one who has the highest amount of points is the winner of the challenge round. And that doesn't mean that you won a show. But in this challenge round, Gustavo Badel was actually able to win against Ronnie. So let's see how that happened. Here, Victor Martinez challenged him to do an abs and thighs pose, and Gustavo won. Now he's challenged by Gunter Schlierkamp, and they're doing back lat spread. So let's see who wins this one. Conditioning wise, it's close, but I would go with Gustavo because his physique just flows better, the proportions are nicer, he has fuller, rounder legs, just better lower body, smaller waist, overall just better flow, and I think he deserves a win in this one, and of course, yes, he won it. So he's in the lead right now, having 4 points, the other guy is having 2, and Victor Martinez having 0 for now. Now we are about to compare Jay Cutler against Gustavo, and it is Jay Cutler who challenged Gustavo, and he's doing most muscular. So who is winning this one? It's close. I mean, look at Gustavo's conditioning, the chest separation, the quad separation and everything, but Jay is just much bigger, much, much bigger. I mean, especially in the legs and overall, like, he's very wide and very, yeah, he won this one for sure. So now Jay is in the lead. He has 10 points and Gustavo has 6. Now again, Victor Martinez versus Gustavo Badel, and every competitor has a right to choose one pose, I think 2 times. So they're doing abs and thighs again. And again, Gustavo Badel wins. So now it's Jay 10 points, Gustavo 8 points. And now again we have Gunter versus Gustavo. But this time around they're doing side chest. The first thing I'm staring at is Gustavo's hamstrings. That hang is crazy. And then chest and his abs also. Very good separation. He was really ripped. He was really peaked perfectly this night. The only flaw that I can notice is glutes. They weren't super shredded. But other than that, he brought a crazy level of conditioning. He really brought it. This was his best. And he is sort of an underrated bodybuilder because he was third this year. And not many people actually know about him. I mean, people who are not very deep into bodybuilding like me. And probably most of you that are watching this channel. Somehow Gunter won this pose. I would never give it to him. I don't think it was even close. I think Gustavo destroyed him in this one. I don't know how that happened. Whatever you guys think, tell me down below. Now, once again, we have Jay Cutler versus Gustavo Badel, and now, take a look at this, like, who looks better now? I would go with Gustavo now, and yeah, Gustavo actually won a point here, actually 2 points, because look, Jay's bigger, but look at how Gustavo flexed right here, so yeah, he showed a lot of detail, a lot of density, especially in the upper body, in the chest and arms area, and the shoulders, legs of Jay are more dominant, but it's not all about the size. So this time around, Gustavo wins, deservedly so. I can make sense of this. When two bodybuilders are very close, the presentation can make a big difference. And now we have the 7-time Mr. Olympia champion, at that time, Ronnie Coleman, against Gustavo Badel. Gustavo is calling a shot, he says, side tricep. And look at this. Look at this. Tell me, who do you think looks better here? Now, of course, Ronnie Coleman is a much better bodybuilder than Gustavo Badel. Yes, he is. You can see him standing there relaxed, you can see that he's just much, much bigger, more muscular, more conditioned as well, especially in the glutes, like Ronnie's glutes were peeled, while Gustavo's were not, at his show, no, they weren't. At least he wasn't flexing them properly, if that was the problem, but in this pose, I mean, the flow, the way he's hitting the side tricep, which is obviously something that Gustavo knew. He knew that Ronnie is not great at side tricep. That was his weakest pose, probably. That and absent eyes. But he went with this one because that was his best pose. Yep, it was his best pose. I mean, look at him right here. He shows very big, very good width through the shoulders. Small waist. great separation through the arms and through the shoulders and everywhere, basically abs, chest, leg, side leg as well. And what is interesting is most bodybuilders, most big bodybuilders, aren't exactly able to show their tricep development in a side tricep pose. However, Gustavo was able to do this. Look at the tricep. So he deserved a win in this one. He was better than Ronnie Coleman in this one. Overall, Ronnie is a better bodybuilder, no doubt about that. But in the side tricep right here, I mean, he's crushing him. Maybe it's close when Ronnie turns around and he shows his glutes. And when he turns forward, but in the side tricep exactly, in the pose, Gustavo wins. And now he's in the lead. He has 12 points against Ronnie. But Ronnie stays. He has a challenge now. He's challenging Gustavo Badel, who is in the lead right now. Ronnie won a year before, so he wants to win again, of course. He is the Mr. Olympia 7 times in a row that year. So he's challenging Gustavo, and the choice, which pose he's gonna choose. What do you guys think? What do you think is his best pose ever? Of course, it's back double bicep. He chooses this one, and now look at Gustavo's reaction. He wasn't happy about that. He wasn't happy that he's gonna have to do rear double bicep against Ronnie. And he basically knows he cannot win this one. No, no. If you talk about the back development, Ronnie is destroying him. If you talk about the conditioning in the glutes and the hamstrings, Ronnie is absolutely annihilating him. So it's not even close. Not even close. I mean, here you can see what kind of bodybuilders these two guys are. And basically, this is the challenge round. But overall in the show, Ronnie won. And this is why. And when they turn around as well, like, you can see that Ronnie was freaking massive. He was massive. And here, Ronnie, of course, wins. So it's 12 against 12. These guys are tied. So who's actually gonna win this challenge round? And now they're having a pose down, which is a final round of the challenge round. And they're hitting a poses whichever they want by their choice. So who do you have here winning? I mean, it's close, kind of, because Gustavo really brought an amazing shape here. And he's a good poser. I mean, Ronnie is a great poser, too. And Ronnie is bigger. So it could go either way, really. I mean, I wouldn't be too surprised if either of these two guys won. But look at the side tricep of Gustavo and the oral presentation. He's hitting these poses one after another. He knows what's going on. He knows he's beating Ronnie Coleman and he's giving all of his. He's giving all his gut. And now he actually wins a point. He wins a 13th point and he wins challenge round against Ronnie Coleman, which is crazy. I mean, Gustavo Badel beating Ronnie Coleman after his 7 Mr. Olympia titles. So, and you guys saw the reaction at the beginning of the video. So Ronnie wasn't happy with this. And he knew he was a better bodybuilder and that he's going to win that show that night. And he won the Mr. Olympia, of course. But he lost the challenge round, which is also something he hated. He wanted to win everything because he was the best bodybuilder that night, unarguably. But Gustavo Badel won the challenge round, and I think he deserved it. I think he deserved it. But Ronnie Coleman is the king, and this was his final Mr. Olympia that he won, and this was the year when he wore this cape and this crown, and yeah, he basically showed it to us that he was the king. He won his 8th Mr. Olympia title that year. Look at the legs here, Jesus. So he was really good this year as well. I mean, the next year, he wasn't exactly on. He lost 2006 against Jay Cutler, but 2005, maybe he wasn't as good as he was, for example, in 1998 or 2003, but he was still unbeatable, basically. I mean, look at the size of this guy. This is just insane. I mean, obviously, I wasn't there. I didn't witness all these things, but his legs, I don't know, based on all the videos and the photos I've seen, his legs seemed bigger this year than any other year, really. So, yeah, it was a shame for Ronnie to lose that challenge round against Gustavo Badel. But of course, he won the Sando, he won the Mr. Olympia. This was your top 5. Victor Martinez, who was really great, who really brought a good level of conditioning this year, and 2 years later, he almost won the Mr. Olympia. Gunther Schlierkamp, not exactly at his best. Gustavo Badel at his best. And Jay Cutler, 1 year from actually winning Mr. Olympia. Next year, 2006, he won it. Even though Ronnie was starting to melt slowly, he was an obvious winner of this show. And Gustavo Badel, even though he won that challenge round, deservedly, he wasn't exactly as good to be second spot. Jay was better, and God forbid he won the show. Of course, he wasn't near Ronnie Coleman's level. Now, in the end, we had Jay Cutler versus Ronnie Coleman. Of course, Jay with his peaceful state of mind, and Ronnie with his excitement, crazy level of excitement every time he won the Mr. Olympia. And after hearing his name, after hearing he won, he fell on his knees just like every other time, which was always dramatic. And that's why we love Ronnie Coleman. So this year, Ronnie Coleman won, Gustavo Dell won the challenge round though. However, whatever you guys think about who deserved to win that challenge round, whatever your thoughts are on this video, tell me down below in the comment section. Like this video if you enjoyed it, and please subscribe, guys, for a lot of videos, a lot of bodybuilding content I'm gonna be posting in the days, weeks, months, and years to come. Thank you so much, guys. All the best, and bye-bye.